6 mile battle. She goes to shore. She goes to shore and she's on the cell. She's got those beat up. And she goes on the shore to the only solid structure she could see, which was a log, which was not a log.
Oh, no.
And that thing shot right under her. Shot right under her kayak and folded for the world. She did not go be after that.
If you go to the Okanoke in the summer, you'll see a lot of lots of religious flying there. So it's also supposed to be fun.
Problem.
You may want to remember that kind of thing. About 10 years ago, there was a big coal first in Brooklyn, Tennessee.
Yep.
I love that one. Five line sales and sound guilty. That's
complete.
Yep. And we also have a full last one Jackson that used to have. So we know what he's for.
So he's talking about a couple of things. Yes, one for a disaster, but two of just cleaning up or shutting down. Shutting down. That stuff gets transported equally everywhere. And unfortunately, we're a recipient at our level of landfill.
Well, Georgia Power is shutting down a bunch of coal plants, which is good that they're doing that. But then they've got these coal ash plants, and they're going to ship it somewhere. Our opinion is they made it, they should, to store it safely on their own property. So, there's a few bills in the legislature, HB 93 and HB 94 by Jeff Jones, which are about these talus and about when they can be watered upon and where they can send it. But the U.S. Senate Bill 123 by Jeff Lindwood, who has Chisholm Island, still there, but it's in school last year. And his bill is to raise the fees. Most people don't know it actually costs less to dispose of the school ash than those household trash in Atlanta.
How about we times 10 that one?
I'd do for that.
I would too.
And then his bill just says match the price of the improvement.
No, if you're going to stick us with that stuff, it's going to cost you an arm and then an arm.
Because the way it is, the tracks go as an out-of-state plan. So we'd like to see all those passed, and then there's one a little more obscure on the green version. Well, speaking of tipping fees for landfills, percent of that is a tax. It's supposed to go into the trust fund, which is supposed to go to things like the entire tax fees that just comes after that.
That rarely gets used for that, or at least about the 1% or 7% over the years I have fallen.
Because a lot of that's converted to the purpose of the general fund and who knows where. So there's a bill, House Resolution 164 by Jay Powell, that proposes to have a constitutional amendment on land on the balance of stocks.
Well, to just do what you promised.
That's right.
If you promised it in the past and you said that's identified for that reason, then it stays identified for that reason. It doesn't get borrowed and stolen from.
Exactly.
Yeah, hats off to Jay for pushing it.
Yeah, and some people are concerned, some of the legislature would if there was like a recession. Well, there's a clause in there, and that's
it. Beautiful. Now, our waterways throughout this state are all wonderful. I've toured them and paddled on them, and they're destinations for me. Are there any bills to absolutely protect them and keep them pristine in some way, shape, or form, or even clean up some of those waterways?
None that I know of. One we're trying to get started is one that you were but basically, it used to be that you could build a certain distance in the river. Nowadays, unless there's a specific set of conditions that you hardly ever see on the river, you build right up off the river, which is not good because I think everyone around here remembers the big floods in 2009. Those were not 70-year rains. They were 70-year floods.
3 years apart.
That's a year short.
That was a quick 7 years.
So, that was largely because of too much clear cutting, too much impervious cover, and more you scour the vegetation about it. And there's more than water just kind of because of blood.
All right, good point. Now, listen, also to draw lots of attention and to help. You guys do a lot of neat events, and I've taken part in a few. So, invite somebody out to maybe one of the next ones that you got coming up.
Well, we've got what you've been on, which is the 7th Big Little River Paddle Race at the Benton State Park. That's
starting at Roberts Landing.
That's right, starting at Roberts Landing and going down from the top of the lake down to East Park. It's only about 3 miles, so it's a nice distance. You can race. The winner last year came several hours from the Atlantic coast of Florida, and he finished in less than 30 minutes.
Now, it's not the guy that wins everything.
No, it's the guy.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good, dethrone the champ.
Yeah, now we all like Dwight Meyer, but he didn't actually come in, so we don't know.
He'll be back next year if he hears of the new king.
Well,
we did. We won for multi-family owner when it was more than three people, and I think we only had two others in the entire category. My girls got competitive and said, paddle faster, daddy, paddle faster.
There you go.
And they have offered a nice drag coefficient when they put their paddles in as well. We will, though. very much enjoyed that event. It's as scenic as scenic could be. I think along the way, we saw some baby alligators, heard them chirping. Yeah. Heard them chirping, and they got up in some of the little island pads and saw them. Didn't see any of the big boys that trip.
You often see a bunch of birds, and I see a great little parrot, our favorite animal.
A little too close to a hanging wasp nest.
Oh, watch out for those.
As well, because there's no way, there's only one way to escape that, and that's in the water. You don't want to do that, but yeah, there was one of the branches that was so weighted down by it that it was hanging about 5 or 6 feet over there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, those can be right in front of you. Watch out.
Quick. All right, so that one's coming up.
Before that, we're going to do the Lackawanna River, Wickelodeon, we have held it for May Days, the Stateville May Days, just a year of the tourists, Campbell's County, down in Stateville. That's a nice one, that's March 23rd. And I'm going to be at several festivals, the Zero Festival as well, Austin, and then the Wild Fruit Festival, Pine Springs, and then we might go to Spring Reunion at Trees of Park. Now we got a big one coming up this summer, which is Paddle Georgia. Paddle Georgia's outfit picks a river every year and paddles for a public on the river. For the first time, they're going to pick it out when he paddles out of state. Out of the Peachy River, starting to build the ramp that's supposed to allow us to down the Peachy and to Florida and then turn right on Swanee and keep going.
Now, can I join you for a day?
You can.
Okay, good. I'm not going to take the week off, but that is a very fascinating stretch and probably one that is much talked about. As well, and that could have coalition down in Florida, the 13 counties that have come together to make sure that we see some of the clean water. Mm-hmm.
No, we can talk about that too. Just to finish up on Cattle, Georgia, yes, we can come just today. And by the way, we have a very stable weather set up broadcasting from.
Oh, listen to that. and I got my AT&T hot, the 100 gig hotspot right there.
Yeah, there you go.
So we can absolutely try that if I bought a cell phone. For a broadcast along the way now.
One more event, and then we'll talk about the other stuff you just brought up, which is August 24th. I'm scrolling down the bottom here because I'm picking this date after printed this newsletter. August 24th here in Valdosta, the Salty Snapper, is the second annual Swanee River Keeper Songwriting Contest, 1 to 5 p.m.
Boy, that was a great first year event last year.
Mm-hmm.
Well, again, just talking and actually knowing some people that could be there. Our buddy David from down at the Spivia Swanee Party.
David Farr, that's right.
Yeah. All right, so listen, we'll help you promote that event. I'm all on board.
Yeah.
That songwriters contest is all about the folklore of our hometown in Florida as well.
And our winner last year, Laura Dalcera, she's going to play at the final piece for California first at Christian Village.
Beautiful.
So, you mentioned. There's one here. You want to talk about that?
Not really.
I don't either. I'm tired of it.
Obviously, you know what I've embarked on, and I'm going to have to address that. It was going to be late.
I can't talk about that. I don't want to see three here.
No, don't worry about it. That's why I didn't go specific, but I will have you know you got a couple of guys in the newspaper sent me almost every piece of research they have done that you had presented with them, articles that you had presented, and said this will be an issue if you're successful in November. So, I took that to heart, and obviously it's something I'm passionate about, so you got a friend in me.
I can say it will be an issue in the mayor's race. That's a 501c3,
Boy, for somebody that's a 501c3, he sure is active in politics. He's at every single meeting with that
issue.
John, listen, you're a joy, and tell Gretchen how to do it. I need to enjoy my time with you guys.
All right. Come back again.
Yep.
Oh, and just one thing. Thank you to the Langdale Company for access to take out of the Paddle Georgia as well as Big Bridge. This is key on the way around the camera.
Is that for a gate?
It is a gate. It's not public access. It lets us have access.
Fantastic. All right, listen, I got my cell number, so call me when it's nice and easy paddle. Call me when it's weak woods as well.
All right.
6 miles and under. I'm in.
Thank you,
John. John, Shenjul, doing great work. Here as well, in Florida as well. It's just waterways in general.
All right,
let's come back. It's the Home Builders Association. What a great group, and I'm so glad that they're putting on their showcase again. It's been missing from this area for a while, but I know it's a lot of work, and just how much as it goes into putting that show on coming up March 1st and 2nd, the Rainwater Conference Center, correct? Thumbs up.